guys, it's Haffina. I'm back again, and it is time for another monthly makeup basket. There are a few other people doing this in collaboration with me. Each month is a themed basket. February's is sexy time song inspired. I don't have too much makeup that's sexy time inspired, but what I did is I went through and I picked mainly products that have some reference that could be construed to be sexual, basically, is what I did. Once again, it is very hot here. Of course, the day I decide to film, it decides to be hot again. Should have filmed yesterday when it wasn't so hot. If you don't know, the southern part of Australia is currently in the midst of quite a severe heat wave and has been for almost 2 weeks now. We had our hottest day since records were kept in January, which was about, for my American friends, about 109 where I live, Fahrenheit. It was pretty hot. There were other places that actually got hotter than that, so again, I have a fan on over here. It's not hugely effective. It's starting to get really humid inside. So once again, I have my fan, and I'm a little bit sweaty, but I'm going to do this anyway. Because, you know, it is what it is. It's part of the process of living in a country like Australia. So, I am going to start, I'm going to put my makeup on, I'm going to talk about it as I'm putting it on, and maybe talk about some other stuff as well. So, I'm going to start with a primer. The primer is the Maybelline Baby Skin. Baby. I've had this for a while. I don't recall ever actually using it before, so it's kind of new as well, even though this is not the new month, that was last month. I actually ended up wearing makeup maybe on about 4 different occasions in January, mainly for filming of videos, and so therefore I didn't really use a lot of stuff out of, I think I used everything except the eye base at least once during the month, but it was just so hot that putting on makeup wasn't really something I wanted to do, and I wasn't really going anywhere, so I didn't really do anything. So February this month is my birthday month. I'm not really planning on doing much anyway. Getting ready to go to uni. Uni starts on the 4th of March. So for my foundation this month, I am going to use the L'Oreal Nude Magic Cushion. Nude. Hence why this one's getting used. I've used this a few times before. I don't love it. I don't hate it. I just kind of, it's a nothing kind of foundation, I guess. As I get older, my skin is getting like a little drier, and so ones like this, which are meant to be glowy, are probably a better bet for someone. And I don't like really heavy coverage. I prefer, you know, a light coverage. My problem with this is that there's a difference between light coverage and feeling like you have no coverage. And as you can see, I have a face demon. I always get one right there. Every time I get my period. And too much information, but I got my period on the hottest day since records were kept. Because Mother Nature is a cow. She wanted to punish me or something. See, as you can see, this gives virtually no coverage whatsoever. It is a very, very light foundation. In fact, I would go so far as to say that this is virtually like a tinted moisturizer. In my humble opinion. And yes, I have had my hair redyed. Today was the first day I wet it since I had it done. As a result, you'll notice that my fingernails are blue from my roots because I'm a head scratcher, and so I end up with blue fingernails. And I'm not worried about it at all. I'm just letting you know so that if you're wondering why my fingernails are blue, you know. This is probably a really good kind of like base for ridiculously hot weather, because you kind of feel like you're not wearing anything and you look like you're not wearing anything too. I realize I look really tired. Probably because I am a little tired. Okay, so for my concealer, I'm going to, this is actually another new one. This is the Rimmel Match Perfection. We'll see. This is in 010 Ivory. It has one of those weird brush tip applicators where you have to like squeeze the product up into it. And, it's not my favourite type of applicator. And ironically, it is a hell of a lot thicker and heavier than the foundation that I'm wearing. Ugh. That's come all squished out too far. Gross. I'm just going to let that sit for a minute. Wonder if it's going to do the same thing that the clean concealer did to me. The clean concealer literally, like, I let it dry down a bit and then I tried to pat it out and it balled up on me and came off. Which is, like, not nice. This is a dry sponge. I'm just going to spray it with a bit of setting spray. Because I can't be bothered going and dampening it. Actually blended out really nicely. I was surprised. So for my powder for this month, mainly for setting under my eyes, I have the NYX HD, which you probably saw heaps last year because I was trying to use it up. And clearly I'm still trying to use it up because I've still got it. I really only try and set underneath my eyes because, as I said, my skin's getting a bit drier and often it just looks cakey and disgusting. So, and that is not a look I enjoy. So, what is that? I'm just going to... I am... sweaty. That is the thing I can say, is I am sweaty. Okay, for my eyebrows this month, I am using the Chella Luscious Light Brown pencil. I'm actually using, got like three different things. They're not exactly sexy time inspired. But, you know, they don't necessarily call brow products by sexy time names, you know. One of the benefits of having weird coloured hair is you can pretty much get away with any brow colour you like. So if this was my natural hair, these brows would be way too dark. They're a little on the thin side, but my brows are a little on the thin side anyway. The next brow product is the Extend Brow, which one could extrapolate to something else being extended. This is like a fibery thing that you put on to give you more volume to your brows, which it actually stays in place pretty well. I have used this before quite a bit. This one's like half full, and I have another one. So, whilst Designer Brands is not my favourite brand, it's an Australian brand. It's okay. And then I just made a mess. For the most part, they stay in place. But I am going to set it all with brow gel anyway. My brows are very bold on my face. And yes, I keep on stopping to fan my face. Hey, it is what it is. As I said, it's hot. I'm just trying to survive here. So, for my brow gel, I have a brand new e.l.f. Clear eyelash and eyebrow gel. Ironically, they're both exactly the same, pretty much. So, you can use both ends. I generally use one end until it starts to look disgusting, and then I use the other end. You can pretty much make it look disgusting almost instantly when you use something like a fiber brow thing. Okay, for my blush, I have two different choices. These are both Makeup Geek products. This one is Rendezvous, which is sort of a palish pink. Well, it's not that pale. It's like a mid-tone pink. And the other one is Love Affair, which is a really, really bright pink, red thing. I think I'm going to... This one's kind of like... Rendezvous is a bit more plummy. So I am going to use Rendezvous today because it's a little less intense. It's a bit powdery, Jesus Christ. I didn't actually buy it from Makeup Geek myself. This is one of the ones that I got from Tamara J last year, year before, as well as the Love Affair one and some eyeshadows. These are super pigmented. I don't know if you guys have heard, depends on how in the beauty news sort of realm you go, but Makeup Geek is actually rebranding at the moment, and they're going to be available in, I think it's Ulta or somewhere like that, and they're selling a whole bunch of their old eyeshadows and stuff, like super duper cheap, and they said they're rebranding, and they're going to have like new products with new names, but it looks like some of them are literally old products renamed. Because, like, she's got the one Cocoa Bear, which is actually in my collection, which was named after her ex-husband. So there's a suggestion that she's just renaming old product. They're not actually new products. I thought that was interesting. Yeah, she's kind of, like, lost direction, I think. For my contour and highlight, I'm going to use the Astralis contour thing. That's basically the contour shade I use, and probably this highlighter here, which is the one with shimmer. This one's a matte. I've got to be really light-handed with this one because it's a little too dark, and because my skin is ever so slightly damp, it's not really going to blend very well. So I'm only going to put it on the back portion. I mean, yeah, I could probably do without the contour, just use the blush and highlighter. That would probably make more sense. I'll take my big blendy brush, which has got just a touch of powder on it from doing under my eyes. Probably on camera, it's not really showing up as much in my mirror. It's not particularly dark, but I don't really want it to be anyway. This is not a highlighter that is glowing to the gods or anything. It's a pretty subtle highlighter. It's not like the green one I was wearing last month, which I have to say I really enjoyed wearing. But I don't have any, like, highlighters are one thing in my collection I don't have a huge amount of anyway. And usually when I do get them, they're really, really disappointing. So, yeah. So that is going to be my highlight and contour for this month. So that is basically the base makeup done. So what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to spray my face now with some setting spray. This is the Lacura one. I don't have very much left. I used a different Lacura one last month, which has a much nicer mister than that one has. And I also found the other day they have a makeup primer spray. So I'll be trying that out next month. Probably. This setting spray needs to dry down, whereas the other Lacura one, it's kind of like sets instantly, dries down instantly. It's not as wet as this one is. I'm sorry if you can't hear me properly because I'm fanning my face. I am going to zoom in so that Omne can see what I'm doing to my eyes. And everybody else who cares about that, to show you the eye stuff that I've got in this month. Okay, for eye primer, I am using the LA Girl Pro Primer in nude, because nude. There's going to be a lot of nude in this, because that's about as far as my sexy time type of names of products goes. I'm actually not one for buying ones that have, ironically, even though I've got like a really dirty mind, I'm not one for buying makeup with rude names, particularly. I actually don't see the point. Like the NARS Orgasm and Deep Throat, I mean, there's just so many other ways that they could name them that would be far more appropriate, quite frankly. And then you've got freaking Too Faced at the moment with their ridiculous names of their products. When I found out that their new makeup line had a product called Pat the Puss, I was just like, you know, in this day and age, with all of the stuff that's going on in the media, is that the best choice? So one of the eyeshadow palettes that I'm going to be using this month is Essence. This is one of their Happiness Is palettes. I got this from Tamara J, and it's really shiny. This is Happiness Is Following Your Heart. So I thought that was appropriate for February. I'm just going to use that to set. I'm using the lightest colour down this end to set the eye primer. Now, sometimes I don't set my eye primer, and sometimes I do, and what you will find, if you are not very experienced and you don't set your eye primer, you'll find that your shadows grab. So if you take a light colour, like around about your skin tone sort of colour, or an all over colour that matches whatever you're doing with your eyes, it will help so that when you put the other colours on, they blend a little bit easier, but everything sticks a bit better, which is why you use eye primer, is to try and help stuff stick better. Some people don't find that it works. Generally, I find that using some kind of creamy type of base will make my makeup on my eyes last longer. The other palette that I am using is the That's Heart palette from BH Cosmetics. I got this from Monica the Diva. I have hit pan in one of the eyeshadows, which is actually the eyeshadow I am going to use to do my transition. Even though none of these are really matte or anything, I personally don't care. I'm not one of those who's going to tell you that you must use a matte shadow in your crease, because I don't necessarily, or as a transition, because I don't always do that. rules are meant to be broken when it comes to makeup, quite frankly. There's another one that says that older women shouldn't use shiny eyeshadows. And I think that's bullshit. There's actually a lady from Canada, a French-Canadian, called Natalie, who uses shiny eyeshadows all the time, and she looks fabulous. I don't care what anybody says. It is all really very much a personal preference. So I'm going to go back into the happy one. Find a different brush. I'm going to go into the second darkest one. I'm just going to... This is a e.l.f. Sea Brush. Going to start adding a bit more depth into that area. So this month is probably pretty much going to be fairly neutral types of looks, nothing too crazy until I do my Gotta Glam Them All and Muppets. But for like an everyday looker, if I'm going out, this is the kind of thing that I'm going to be doing, is a fairly neutral eye look. And then I'm going to go in to the darker shade on the end. Pat some on the outside corner. Pick up a blending brush and blend it towards the center. These kind of blend away a little bit. I haven't really used this palette much, but if you find your shadows are blending away, put more shadow on. I was watching Cara Mascara Cakes, and she was saying, you know, when you think you put on enough eyeshadow, put on more. Because sometimes what you see is not what other people see. Like, you might think it's over the top, but it's actually not. And the other thing is if you're going to go to all the trouble of putting eyeshadow on or makeup on or whatever, you know, you might as well have it be noticeable. I really don't understand the no makeup, makeup look thing. You know, if you don't want to look like you're wearing makeup, don't wear makeup. And I'm going to take this lovely pointy brush, and I'm just going to run that really dark, like the darkest one I've used, which is still on the end of the brush. Just run that under the eyes, join up with the outside corner. So just a really simple look, nothing too complicated, not trying to be fancy schmancy here or anything. Alrighty. Well, we are going to be slightly fancy schmancy. I have the other eyeshadows that I have for this month. I have Diamond Lust from NYX, which is a white, which I will probably use at some stage. I have Nymphette from Glamour Double Eyes, which is a really dark focus, purpley glitter thingy. What's it? I'll do a look with that later in the month, just so you can see. And the other one I have is Bare Naked, which is that colour. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take, if I can find it, I know I've grabbed one. I'm just going to grab a small brush. I am going to put some setting spray on it. And then I'm going to put that on the lids. Now, for those of you who are not like really into makeup and don't understand, when you use like a pigment, if you use a setting spray or like Fix Plus or something like that, it's what they call foiling, and it's something you can do with pigments. You can't do it with all pressed eyeshadows. You can do it with some, particularly like lids and stuff like that, but it works particularly well with loose pigments. And with some colours, it just makes them just like pop off the eyeballs. It just looks really, really cool. So if you hear a beauty guru say that they're foiling a shadow, literally it just means they're using it wet. It would probably be much easier if they just said, I'm using it wet, but... And this one's got like ever so slight, like goldy hint to it, which is just really pretty. Just stepping it up a notch. So that's Bare Naked from Glamour Doll Eyes. I am not going to, because it's real hot. I do have a liquid eyeliner in this particular project, or this makeup basket this month. It's one that's never actually been opened. This is the Ulta Felt Tip Eyeliner. I'm actually going to use it today because the last time I did that, on a really hot day, it ran down my face, even though I set it. So instead, what I'm going to do is go into the That's Heart palette, and I'm going to go into this one right here, which is not actually black. It's really, really dark brown. I'm going to take a tiny detailer brush. This is actually the F16 from AOA Studio, which is Shop Miss A. And I'm just going to press that along the lash line. So all it does is just darken up along that lash line a little bit. I'm not going for a wing, I'm not like... I'm just keeping it sort of soft and gentle. And then I'm going to take the same one and just run it really close to the lash line at the bottom.
Yeah.
I have... For eyeliners, I have the Rimmel Exaggerate Waterproof in Nude, in the nude, even more appropriate, which I am going to use on my waterline. And I also have my Lancôme Noir, which means night, which is when you should have naked sexy time, isn't it? I don't know. It's just black. And I'm going to tight line with it. So tight lining is when you line the opposite of this one here. This one's called your waterline. And this one up above, which is just under your lashes. If you have a look, see how it is really, really pink. This one is now black. Now, if you have really light skin like I do, and you make your lash line really dark but don't tight line, you kind of get this weird light line that goes underneath where your lashes are, and it looks a little bit weird. The other thing that tight lining will do is make your lashes appear to be thicker and more full, which is what they want, you know. So it's just a little trick, and it takes a little bit of practice to actually do it. Take your time, go slowly, try to stay as close to the lashes as possible. You're not trying to colour in the inside of your eyelid, you're just trying to do the little bit that is sticking underneath where your lashes are, just to sort of meld it all together. And I'm going to curl my lashes a little. As you can see, I have super light lashes naturally. And this month, the mascara I'm using is the Purple Lash Princess from Essence. I don't think I've actually used this before, but it has a curved wand. And I got it on my skin. Always get it on my skin. And the long form has transferred to the bottom. Okay, I am gonna zoom out and finish off my makeup. So, for my lips again this month, I have quite a number of options. Trying to give myself choices, etc. Turns out, I went through, I have a thing, it's called Airtable, which is sort of like it's a bit like Google Documents, but different, but similar. It's like a spreadsheet type thing. And I have all my makeup listed on there. So I'd gone through all the names, and I just picked out names that fit the kind of theme. So the naked sexy time theme. And as a result, I ended up with a lot that looked very similar. So for my lip liner this month, I have the Lacura, I believe it's called After Dark, and it needs sharpening. The Lacura lip liners don't have any names on them, but the lipstick did, and actually I think this one's the Head Over Heels, this is Head Over Heels, and it goes with the matte lipstick, which is Head Over Heels. So, let's Head Over Heels, the lip liner. This is Head Over Heels, I believe that was what it is. It has no name on it. It's a matte lipstick. Actually quite a light wear matte lipstick. It looks really pink in the tube and it comes out orangey. It's weird. I also have another from Lacura. This is After Dark. This is a bullet lipstick. It's quite a bit deeper. I have the Sultry Revlon Matte Balm, which is that one there, which has never been used, by the way. I have from Calvin Klein Desire. which is actually pretty similar to Off the Dock. That's the Calvin Klein that's Off the Dock. I didn't actually look at these, I just pulled them out. I'm like literally looking at them now. And I have two lip glosses, I guess they are. This one is Beauty For Real. It's called Kiss Me. It's right there. And I have Be A Bombshell in Hooked. Like, Hooked Up. Which has a lot more pigment to it than that. So I think over this lip stick, I'm going to put the Kiss Me one from Beauty For Real. It's very minty smelling. So I'm assuming it could be a lip plumper type of dealio. It doesn't actually say. Has nothing on it, but it's one of those ones that has a light up, like the Gerard Cosmetics, it has the light up thing for funsies. So that is my look with the stuff that was in my makeup basket. Obviously I didn't use everything because I have so many like lip products in, and you know, I have options. So yeah, that is it for this month's makeup basket. If you want to subscribe, click the button down there. Leave me a thumbs up if you like makeup basket and makeup type videos, and leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments, and I'll see you in my next video. See ya!